You know, there are not many songs that make you want to sing along and laugh at the same time, and it's hard to laugh and sing. But Peacock's new hit series, Girls5eva, has more than 30 awesome songs that do just that. Oh, and so much more, Hoda.
Y'all, it is super duper hot. It's in fuego. The show's getting Emmy buzz. It follows a 90s girl group looking to make a comeback 20 years later. Tina Fey happens to be executive producer of this laugh out loud comedy. And we've been waiting for you, Tina. She's joining us in person. Come down the red carpet, Tina.
Let's go, Tina.
Yes.
Just whatever you like.
Stretch it out. It's your moment.
Can we do something that we haven't done in a long time?
Yes.
Hug someone.
We can? Oh, my gosh.
I just have a slight head cold, but don't worry.
Stop it.
I would welcome a head cold. Guys, I am so honored to be here. I don't know how I got to be this person, but I want to thank all of you guys for keeping all of us outside 1A, like, tethered to reality for the last year and a half. Every milestone that you guys, when you guys came back together, these were such, like, uplifting moments of optimism for the rest of us. So thank you, and thank you so much for inviting me to be here.
That's so sweet.
Were we on your pandemic bucket list after it was over?
Yes. 100%.
Well, you were on ours.
Yes.
I mean, there's so much to talk to you about, but let's, because we actually celebrated your 50th birthday together on Zoom.
Yes, I remember, and you guys gave me golden double-stuffed Oreos.
I know, we're good like that. I mean, but now you have a big entrance. It's even better. What's the last year been like for you? Mm-hmm. What does it feel like is to get back to normal?
Yeah, it feels great to be here. You know, we were lucky enough that we were able to work. NBC Universal took really good care of us and our crew, and so we were able to make Girls5eva and to finish the season of Mr. Mayor during the pandemic. Mm-hmm. And it is, you know, to be able to be around other people and make things has been a great blessing for all of us.
I think, I mean, this show made it, we feel like it's like the Ted Lasso for girls. Like,
yeah.
It's so much fun to watch. We loved it. But I was just thinking, you created this thing during the pandemic.
Yeah.
Now you've got Emmy buzz. Now you're renewed for season two.
Yesterday morning, yes, Girls5eva will be back for season two.
Yes.
So all the more reason to check out season one on Peacock now. My friend Meredith Scardino is the creator of the show, and she is just one of the funniest people
ever. Did you
ever.
Know, like, did you think we got, this is gold right here. We have something going.
Yeah, I knew that Meredith was a joke machine.
Yeah.
And then once we were able to get this cast, Sarah Bareilles and Renee Elise Goldsberry, mm-hmm. Busy Phillips, Paula Pell, once I just feel like you know when something is very juicy.
Well, the cast is so magical. I mean, they really mix. And I mean, it's the music, it's the funny writing, it's all of it together. But I mean, you have folks like Sarah Bareilles said she was super nervous because she's a great singer. She hadn't really thought about being an actress or a comedic actress.
Yes, I had seen Sarah in Waitress on Broadway. I was like, oh, she's a wonderful actress. And I had seen her be really funny hosting the Tony Awards and stuff. And I was like, I think, and also I just really like casting. I like finding people and so once we got her, and she's fantastic. She's an absolute natural.
Well, the music is the other star of the show. I'm sorry. Those songs, I was literally almost peeing my pants listening to some of them. Who came up with all those songs?
Thank you for asking. The music is, you know, my husband, Jeff Richmond, has been writes pretty much all the music for the show, with the exception of a song. And Meredith Scardino, she, I would say, wrote the bulk of the lyrics along with the writers of the show.
Can we play the Tiny Butts song?
Please.
It's so funny. I think we have a teeny clip.
A tiny clip of Tiny Butts.
You're part of Girls5eva, right?
Yeah.
I remember you. You had that song on the soundtrack of Blue Crush.
Well, yeah, TBF.
TBF, Tiny Butts forever, to silver dollar, pancakes and jeans. This will be what people act forever. TBF, Tiny Butts in Jeans.
Tiny Butts in Jeans. I mean, right on.
I think Meredith is great at nailing those kind of jokes where it's calling out, like, things from the 90s, we were like, that's crazy. And the idea that, we're going to like Tiny Butts forever. And then Jeff makes the songs sound really good and the women sing really well. So you have the earworm plus the jokes.
That's the kind of the humor of it. It's like, it actually sounds really good. And then you listen to the words and you're like, that is ridiculous.
Wait, you know what I was just thinking in the second? What if we had like a Girls5eva Today Show
concert?
Let's do it today.
No, but could we? We have a summer concert series. Could you imagine? By the way, those girls can sing off the hook together. That harmony is great.
They sound great together.
They're there's another rising star in the show.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Her name is Penelope Richmond.
Yes.
Do you know her?
I do know her. I live with her.
You gave birth to her.
I gave birth to her, and I will be cooking her vegetarian chicken nuggets later. Our daughter, Penelope, ended up being in the show. There was a part for a 9-year-old, and I was like, if we don't let her audition for this, she's going to kill us.
But you didn't give her the part.
No. Well, she auditioned, she put herself on tape, and then, you know, Meredith was like, should we give her the part? And I was like, no, you can't. I can't let, you know, the boss's kid get the first job they ever auditioned for. But she's like, but she did really well. So we ended up, we hired another kid, and then because of the pandemic, the kid was out of state and couldn't come in, and I was like, Penelope, you're up. And she did a great job, and she was super professional, and, you know, for like a kind of a grim year of like distance learning, all that stuff, it was a little treat for her. It is funny when you have your first kid, you're like, oh, absolutely not. You're so strict. And then your second kid, you're like, what do you want?
Do it.
You want to get a tattoo? So, let's do it.
Exactly.
Wait, were you super nervous too?
I know the whole crew forever. Yeah. It's like the crew's been with us since 30 Rock. And so I felt like, no matter what, it would be okay. But I was very, very proud of her because, you know, it's one of those moments where you're like, oh, you brought all your manners today. Oh. Like, that's the main thing, right, as a parent. And I'm like, oh, your manners were lovely.
Exactly. Please don't pick your nose. That's all we're asking.
No, she would never.
Now, there's a cameo from one Carson Daly, but it's a vocal cameo.
Yes,
How did this come about?
I've been trying to slow play Carson onto the show. Now that we know there's a season two, don't think I won't be back, Carson.
Let's go.
It was the middle of the pandemic. Uh-huh. We didn't want to bother you too much. At first, we were casting a lookalike because we have these flashbacks to old music videos and old TRL. And it was cracking me up because we were trying to cast a Carson Daly look-alike, sound-alike, and my husband was like, every guy, we were like, what about this guy? And he was like, no, Carson has piercing blue eyes. I'm like, all right, buddy. But I think it's because he has blue eyes, too, and he knows they're, like, the most valuable weapon. And so we ended up begging Carson to voice over. So, because honestly, Carson, you're iconic, and like, it doesn't work.
I wanted to do it in person, actually, but with the pandemic, it was, like, impossible.
It was madness. I think you were doing the voice.
Yeah. But that's why we've got season two. All right, let's talk about your other show, Mr. Mayor. I'm going to roll a clip, and then let's talk about it.
Okay, great.
Hey, Tommy, how much do we spend to take care of the city's palm tree?
Oh,
$50 million a year, sir.
50? You have any idea how many miles of bus lane I could buy with that? A bunch, I'll bet.
Sir, I have been trying to call attention to this topic for years. Palm trees are not even supposed to be here. Most of them were planted for the 1932 Olympics to trick people into thinking LA wasn't a waterless scorpion graveyard.
So palm trees are expensive, dangerous, and they shouldn't be here in the first place.
Like an NFL franchise, sir.
Holly Hunter, Ted Danson, this is incredible, and you're writing season two right now.
Yeah, we're writing season two right now. Season one also available on Peacock, though, if you want to check it out. And it's, Ted Danson, Holly Hunter, Vella Lavelle, Mike Cavallon, and our own beloved Bobby Moynihan from SNL, and they are just also a dream cast.
Well, Tina, thank you. You're going to come back and join me and Jen at 10, because we got more to talk about, and we're also going to have a special performance of Girls5eva. I think it's the song that Sarah Bareilles wrote.
Yes.
You can also catch Mr. Mayor streaming, as she said, on Peacock.
Do you want to do a big exit since you did a big entrance? We can roll some music.
Yes, please. Okay.
Show that tiny butt.
Oh, I can't show you a tiny butt, but I can show you a 21st century butt.
Woo! Tina Fey, first live guest in the
love
studio.
You, Tina.
Hey, thanks for watching our YouTube channel. Find your favorite recipes, celebrity interviews, uplifting stories, shop our favorite deals, and so much more with the Today app. Download it now.